Hello, gorgeous girls, and welcome back to my channel. So today we are going to be talking about how to really lose that mummy tummy. So if you feel like you've got a little pooch or you suffer from diastasis recti, definitely keep watching. And if you're new here, hello, I'm Tracy. I put out brand new fitness, wellness, and lifestyle videos every single day, so I would love it for everybody. Make sure to click on that little red subscribe button and also click on that little bell icon because that's gonna let you know every single time I have a brand new video that goes live. So I have been asked about healing DR, AKA diastasis recti or diastasis recti. I don't know what the right pronunciation is, but we'll probably change it up during this video so much recently. It's probably because I'm about 8 months pregnant now. I think I'm actually a little bit more now. So I'm 33 weeks pregnant. Yes, I'm just slightly over 8 months pregnant. And it's just been coming up all the time here on YouTube and from my tribe and the Transformer tribe and Total Body Transformation. People keep asking me about it. So here's the good news. The good news is if you have it, you absolutely can heal it and improve it. So yay to that. Here's the other news. You're not special or unique or a unicorn if you have it. And here's what I mean by that. 1 in 3 women suffer from diastasis recti. So most women, a lot of women all over the world get this. So what causes it? Well, first, what is it? Basically, you know, think of your six-pack muscles, okay? So that's your rectus abdominis. There's always a slight separation in between, you know, the packs, whether you have a six-pack or not. Like, this is just anatomy. We all have it, you know, whether it's underneath some fat or a baby or whatever, right? But when we have diastasis recti, that gap separates, okay? So we don't want that, and that actually can give you that feeling, even if your kid is 20 years old, of having that pooch that you just never lost. It absolutely can be improved, and I'm gonna show you how to improve it here today, okay? You can test it really easily. I'm not gonna do it because I am 8 months pregnant, so I'm gonna just explain it to you really easily. So what you would do is just lie down on the ground, and you would just do a normal little curl or a little crunch up, okay? Then you would take your fingers, and if you can put one finger or two fingers, that's completely normal, okay? But if you've got 3 fingers or more in that gap, then you know you've got diastasis recti, okay? Some people don't even realize they have it. They just think they've got a poochy belly. So do that test just to see. Now, if you've got, you know, even 2 or 3 fingers of a gap, you definitely want to go talk to your OB, okay? Go talk to your doctor about it and just, you know, make sure everything is okay. I'm sure that it is, but I'm not a doctor here, so you just want to consult with your OB. So a danger of having diastasis recti is also that it can really cause low back pain. And when you think about it, here's why. Not only for the you know, vanity reasons, which I get it, girl, so you don't have to worry about it with me, you know, having that belly pooch, but because those muscles are weaker, so if this was your belly, that means that your back is working overtime. So, you know, because these muscles are not doing their job, something's gotta take over so your back starts working. So what we wanna do is start getting those muscles stronger so that not only will you create that flatter tummy look, but also your back muscles will start releasing. That's why, you know, in Pilates, so many people say like, oh, my back feels so much better, I feel so much more elongated, because we're working those deepest layers of muscle. So what causes diastasis recti? Well, pregnancy is probably the number one cause for it. So if you've had a really big baby or if you've had multiple pregnancies, that's when most women find that they have diastasis recti. So before we get in how to heal it, I want to tell you what to not do. So let's put a big old red X through these exercises. Traditional crunches until you've healed it. Now, when I was a Pilates instructor, I had students and clients that would come to me with DR, and you know what, we would work on it, and then once they were better, they could do all the things. So the good news is this does not have to be permanent for you at all, but you do want to avoid traditional crunch exercises. Anything that's going to really work your rectus abdominis, getting those six-pack muscles. We don't want to do that if you have that separation until the muscles have come together and are healed. So no crunches, okay? You also want to avoid plank exercises. So, you know, straight up planks, holding it, you know, even if it's on your forearms, you don't want to do that because it also does cause a lot of intensity and work on your rectus abdominis, and that can cause that separation to increase. And lastly, we don't want to do a ton of twists. So what do I mean by that? If you were doing like bicycle crunches or something with a weight, that can also exacerbate it, okay? So be mindful, and you can also kind of feel it, you know? If you're doing exercises where your standing abs are great, or if you're like rounding your spine and you're feeling that deep muscle, those are things that you can do. And I'm gonna show you the number one thing that you should be doing absolutely every single day. But like I said, avoid traditional crunches, avoid planks, and avoid major twists with your body because that can cause that separation to get even larger. So I'm going to explain to you exactly how to do the number one exercise to really help improve and hopefully heal your diastasis recti, okay? So what you're going to do, I'm going to talk it through and then I'll insert some clips here. So if you put your hands on your belly here, okay, and you take a nice big deep breath and you want to create that expansion, okay, so your belly gets bigger, then exhale, draw that navel into the spine without changing anything. So here with this big old baby, I'm just drawing that baby up and into my spine, giving her a little hug. Now I want to keep that and take a deep breath without expanding. So I'm letting my back kind of move like an accordion. So inhale, and then exhale and keeping that drawing in. Do it again, inhale, and exhale, okay? So as you're doing that, and you want to do that, work up to about 10 minutes. Now, for bonus points, you could also do some Kegels, okay? So you're contracting your pelvic floor. You know we're all doing it. We all do it when we say that word, right? So basically, it's like if you had to go to the bathroom, if you had to urinate, right? And you kind of stop that flow of urine. When you do the exhale, you can also do that because that will also help to strengthen your pelvic floor, which also, if you've had children or, you know, like me, about to have children or child, it's a really, really good thing to strengthen. We want that, okay? So you can kind of incorporate those two together. But if you wanted to just focus on the core here, that's great. Now, here's why that works. It works because we're contracting your deepest layer of muscles. That is your TA, AKA your transverse abdominis. So I work this all the time, whether you know it or not. Why? Because I'm a Pilates instructor for over 20 years. So my transformers and the transformer tribe know that I'm always saying, you know, keep that belly pulled in, keeping it drawn in. And really one of my famous sayings is the only time your belly should be completely relaxed is whether you're sleeping or dead. And I have to tell you that even at over 8 months pregnant, I'm still not fully relaxing. Like I have to consciously think about like, let it go. There is still, and I know you can't see it as much, but I'm still keeping a little bit of a lift with my deepest layer of muscle, with my transverse abdominis, so that, and that's also what I attribute to not getting so much back pain. So all of my workouts that you find inside of Total Body Transformation, you're going to be focusing on that deepest layer of muscles because I just can't help myself. It's just who I am, is what we do. So again, that is how you can really heal or at least do a major, major improvement with your diastasis recti, okay? If you have it and it's really pronounced, as always, you know, check with your doctor first, but just doing about a 10-minute cycle daily of that deep belly breathing and really focusing on contracting in your transverse abdominis, that deepest layer of muscle, can really help you to train those muscles to come back together. One other thing to remember, when you're taking your inhale and you're contracting in the belly, a lot of times people do this, I'll do it totally wrong. Okay, I'm not gonna move my belly, I'm not gonna let that expansion happen, but they start going. No, nothing here is moving. I should be able to balance a cup of coffee on your head and put some tea on your shoulders. So everything else is completely relaxed. And all that's happening is just this slight expansion of your rib cage up here, but that belly is going from deep to deeper to deeper, all right? So I want to hear from you because I know so many of you have been asking me about this. So please do leave me a comment down below. In addition to this, there are what I have found 5 big fitness mistakes that you're probably making that you didn't even know you were making. So I'll leave a link down below this video and up here in the eye for you to get my ultimate cheat sheet. This is gonna really bust through those mistakes that you didn't even know that you were making to get you right on the right track. So you definitely wanna grab that as well. All right, that's what I've got for you. I really, really hope that this was helpful for you. I really hope that I don't get it, but if I do, I'll know how to heal it. So that's what I've got for you. You are awesome. Please make sure to like this video, give it a big thumbs up, and share it with your friends, and I'll see you next time.